researcher, weren't you?
Yeah.
When you started off.
Yeah. Which is 15 years ago. The summer.
How many?
15.
It seems the other day, doesn't it?
Yeah. And they were playing, they had records playing in the car, you know, it's like the top 40 Pick of the Pops.
Oh, yes.
From that year, and it was like 15 years ago.
I know, oh, yes. What was you, oh, Jean went to see Priscilla in the week at the Palace.
Who's Priscilla?
It's a film. Oh. A musical show,
Yeah.
Palace. It's all about transvestites.
Oh, Priscilla, Queen of the Desert.
Queen Theatre, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I think it was the Queen, or was it the Palace?
Oh, no, is it...
Is it the Palace, oh? That's me. And she said it was 1988 music. So I said, oh, you'd know that. She said, yes, she knew the music, you see.
Yeah.
From her time, you know. Came from Brighton, you see.
So,
I got discharged then.
Well, when you were pregnant with...
Pregnant, yeah.
With Dad.
Your granddad had just got forms for me to be a officer. Not just a leading aircraft woman. He wanted me to have a commission because he got one.
Yeah, well, how... Oh, I don't know where to start, really.
Actually, I was I was called up in 1942.
And you said you were at the Ovaltine.
Well, I was working. That was working in the Ovaltine offices, and it was called Wanda, a Swiss firm.
Yeah.
And then I had papers in, and they got me.
Called up.
Yes, well, I was called up, but they got me delayed for a while. That they needed me, you know.
What, the Ovaltine factory?
The Ovaltine offices, no, in Kensington.
Oh, okay.
The offices.
What did you do there?
Oh, well, I was learning shorthand, so I was doing shorthand typing. I was getting to be a short... Because once you were married then, you had to leave a firm, you know.
I didn't know that.
So a woman left because she got married, so yeah. I got the job. The manager shorthand typist.
So, and... This was in 1939?
Yes, it would be 1939, 40.
Yeah. 19. So did you start working there before the war started?
Yes, I started before.
And then war was declared?
Declared in 1939. And I got the call-up papers, you see, and they deferred me. They got me deferred for a while.
And the company managed to do that?
Yeah, must have done. I got deferred for a while,
yeah.
But then I was called up and they couldn't do any more again, you see. They deferred me for a while, which I don't know how many months.
Yeah.
And then I was first of all, I went for an examination for the ATS, and they wouldn't accept me because I wore specs.
What's the ATS?
The Army Girls. Territorial Army.
Right.
Yes. They wouldn't accept me for that, but they accepted me in the WAAFs.
And did you choose to go to the WAAFs?
No, I didn't choose anything. I just said what I was to do. I didn't choose anything because I didn't want to volunteer.
Yeah.
So when it was the WAAFs, I didn't mind.
Yeah.
So then I went to Gloucester, called up and went to Gloucester, and the family saw me off at the station.
Yeah.
And... got kitted out there. We laid it in. What was these army sheds? You know, these army.
Oh, like Nissan huts.
Nissan huts. Thank you. You'll have to come to my rescue. I stayed in for the night in a Nissan hut with lots of other girls, which I wasn't used to that sort of situation.
Yeah. So where were you living when you were working at Ovaltine?
Oh, I was in Ealing.
With your mum and dad?
Yes. Sometimes I cycled there.
And what were they doing at the time?
Who?
Your mum and dad.
Oh, my dad was a printer.
Right.
And I think sometimes mum did making jam.
Yeah.
Two teachers retired, and they were got their they were private schools, I think, and they started making jam. And mum must have seen a notice somewhere that she was helping them. Well, she took their dogs out for a walk.
Yeah.
And she was buying us a, was it a piano? Was it something? She did jobs like that to buy a piano and for us to have music lessons.
Yeah, yeah. So and this was in Ealing. Can you remember where you lived? Because I don't know any of this. Where do you know where in Ealing it was? The address or anything?
Oh no, I don't remember where. Because she used to go when they went away.
Yeah.
She used to go to their house and take the dog out, you know, for walks and things like that.
Yeah.
And I can't remember what the address is.
Yeah. But you so you lived in Ealing, so you commuted into the Ovaltine.
Into Kensington, yes. Every day.
And you were there before the war, and then...
Before the war, yes.
And then, do you know how... Do you know roughly when you joined the WAAF?
Yes, in 42.
42, so it's a good 3 years still in the office.
Yes, I must have been. I must have gone there at 15.
Yeah.
I must have done. And I went through different departments until I got to be a manager's typist, shorthand typist. I know I cycled, and yet when I first bought a bike, my dad bought me the bike. I said, I'll pay you back, but I never did. It was only about 30 bob, you know, then.
Yeah.
So I used to go out with Grandad, with Eric, and we used to go riding around somewhere. I wouldn't go right because I couldn't go right, so I had to keep going round to the left.
What, because you were scared to turn
scared
into
to
the
turn
traffic?
Right, yes.
So you had to just keep going.
And then in the end, I cycled to Kensington. So I got over that.
So I don't know, when did you meet Grandad? Was that?
Oh, 16. I was 16 at evening classes.
So that was in around sort of 1930.
1940? 1931. 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, 31, about 16.
Right.
No, it was before 16 I met him. I'm sure I wasn't 16. What was I doing? I was doing learning shorthand, you see.
Right, in evening classes.
Evening classes.
And
he was doing everything, like accountancy, drama, everything.
Oh, different lessons.
Oh, yes, we weren't the same.
Yeah.
Because he said, he saw me, I don't know whether the principal was probably acknowledging us all and thanking us for going and coming and do this, that and the other. I can't remember what we were told to do.
Yeah.
And he's supposed to have seen me in the ring. He must have said to someone, who is that over there? And they said, oh, that's... they thought it was somebody else. He didn't know it was me, my name at all. So he must have got to know me that way. I don't remember all that. I must have met him there and got chatting.
Yeah.
And proceeded from there.
And what job was he doing at the time?
Oh, he was working in Hoover's at that time.
Was he?
Yeah, that was his first job. Who was in the Perivale.
Do you know what he did there?
No, I should think it just...
Engineering.
Just office work, I should think. And because the next job, he went to... went to Hayes. Went to Hayes, that's what the Borough Council. And then he went to Greenford.
Borough Council.
Yes, and that was all to do with Ealing Borough Council.
Right.
All to do with that.
And was that in cleansing or?
It must have been, yes. It must have been still. I don't know whether it was called cleansing or not, but it was.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then, of course, when he was called up, when he got discharged, he did all the exams for engineering. Because they couldn't get to, he wanted to go to university, but he couldn't pay for it then. I don't know if they were taking adults then, just after the war,
yeah,
do you?
Yeah, no? I don't
know. I wouldn't know that.
Yeah, yeah.
So he did it at home, like the, we got, I don't know, it wouldn't be like the Open University.
Yeah.
That's where he did all his exams.
Okay.
He passed engineering, he passed in two lots of engineering, because I got rid, I threw the certificates away when I moved from Castledore.
Yeah, yeah. So when you were working at Ovaltine, Grandad was working in
Hoover's.
In Hoover's, but was he immediately called up?
No, when he volunteered.
Right.
I guess knowing your Grandad, he would volunteer for something he wanted to do. He wouldn't want to be told what to do or what services to go in.
So he went to the RAF?
Yes, RAF. Volunteer Volunteer. I've forgotten all lots of these things. Volunteer reserve, I believe. He was a volunteer, first of all, in the RAF.
Okay. So that was in 1939, he went straight away into the RAF.
Either 39, I guess.
And was he based in North Holt then, or...?
We went to, yes, North Holt, West Drayton.
Right.
North Holt.
Okay.
And then Uxbridge.
Right.
And then, of course, I think it was the year that I was pregnant, so that would be 44, wouldn't it? February, he was called abroad then.
Right. So,
that was when I was discharged at the Christmas.
Yeah.
In the RAF.
In Christmas 42?
Yes, 42, when I was married, yes, because I was married while I was in the WAAFs.
Yeah.
I first went to, as I said, Gloucester to get kitted out. Then we were sent to Morecambe to do our training.
Yeah.
And then after that, I was just sent to Bournemouth.
Yeah.
With the Canadians. Stayed there for a few months, and then we were sent to Brighton.
Right.
With the Australians.
Right.
And I was a stencil typist then, because they ask you when they interview you.
Yeah.
What are you doing, you say?
Yeah.
As I was in an office, naturally they wanted me to do the same sort of thing in the WAAFs.
Yeah, yeah.
I would have liked to have learned to drive, really, because that would have got over my... I would have had to do it, wouldn't I?
Yeah.
Would have got over my fear.
When they provide the training for that kind
That's
of thing.
That's right. But, and then I was discharged from Brighton. So it was not exciting at all.
Yeah, yeah.
The Maoris were there, you know, so we had part, you know, the concerts and dances.
Yeah.
Naturally.
So how does that work? That they had like different nationalities in different towns. You know, you said that Australians were in Brighton. Is that they just use that as a base for the Australian Air Force?
Because I worked in the. I think they were all waiting to be sent somewhere abroad, you see.
Yeah.
And I was doing officers' records,
right.
Stenciling them.
Right.
Had to be run off. And it was in the hotel I worked that Maggie Thatcher was in, you know, it was bombed.
Yeah, the Grand Hotel.
That's
where you worked?
I worked in that one. And our hotel where I lived was just a few doors down the road, another hotel, small one.
Yeah, yeah. So when you were working there, could you... Was there any flying nearby, or is it just like an administrative base?
It is administrative.
Oh.
That's all.
And did they clear the people out of the town then?
No.
So it's a normal town?
Normal town. Because I used to go get the station from Brighton to... was it Victoria?
Yeah.
Because your granddad was still at Uxbridge, and he used to come up and meet me, and then he used to take me back when I went on Sunday night.
So you'd stay there during the week in Brighton,
mm.
And they'd pick you up in a hotel.
Off, sometimes you have to stay there, you know. You get you work so many weeks, and then you have to have a week on duty, as they call it, not doing anything, but you're there, you know.
Yeah. So did you live in Brighton then, and go home for the weekend, or
at the hotel? Yes. All week, and then I used to go home on Friday night.
Was it run like a hotel, or was it like a sort of WAAF
thing.
Well, I think it was more like a WAAF, not like a hotel.
Yeah, yeah.
It was Hoplis Hotel, but it wasn't really.
They just used the building?
Yeah, just used the building.
So you had what, sort of WAAF rations?
5 inches, there? You know, of water, and all the bars were painted. We had 3 in our room, and you have to make your bed every day. And
yeah. Well, the water line was painted.
On the bath.
So you couldn't put more water in?
No, you don't know the 5 inches, I think it was. Because the showers weren't even conceived then, were they?
So you had to fill the water up to the line that was painted on.
Yes.
And just going back, just because it's interesting, because I don't know how.
You're just bringing it back to me because I can't.
Yeah. No. It's yes. just to sort of follow the story. Mm. Grandad went into the RAF,
yes.
And you were in you were in Kensington initially,
yes.
For 3 years.
That's right.
And so did you meet Grandad at the weekends then? Because he was in.
Well,
or
he was working. No, he's.
Was he just
used to cycle
place?
Over at night. Used to see him most days.
Oh, okay. Because you were living in Ealing, and he was living
in Greenford.
Right.
And he was.
With his mum and dad?
His mum, his dad died while I was going with him. He was over with me one night, and his uncle came and a friend to say that his dad had died at work at 40, I think it was just 42 or 47, I can't remember.
Yeah.
He'd had a heart attack.
Oh.
And Eric remembered the night before, the day before, that he'd got pains in his shoulder.
And this was Alexander Mossy.
So, and he must have collapsed in the lavatory, I think, on the cloakroom at work. I think he worked too. Oh, God, where did he work now? No good me, trying to remember that.
Yeah, I can't remember what he did.
I think he was some sort of an engineer.
Yeah.
No, it won't come to me. Quite local, really. I think Paddington area. Westbourne Park, was it?
Okay,
I think
yeah.
That's where he worked. So.
Oh,
with the railways.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. And then you went to Gloucester initially.
Got called out, had to go kitted out somewhere in Gloucester. Innsworth, I think it was Innsworth.
Okay.
I can't even remember
the name. That rings a bell. I think we've driven past that.
Not far away.
Yeah,
anyway.
Yeah. And what was your rank? I don't know the terminology.
Just an ordinary leading is it leading aircraft woman, something like that. Just
right.
No rank.
Yeah.
Just the lowest of the low.
And did they train you for a
just
particular?
Just for marching. That's all we had to learn, marching. And the first day we were there. I just don't know how it was, or whether we were just sent round to the commands that we were with. But Vera Lynn was on at the theatre.
Oh, okay.
So we all went along there. Some, you know, you soon make friends with people, don't you?
Yeah. How did it feel going to... Were you in Gloucester for long?
No. Was it a week? I don't know. It was just about
just
a week
a bit marching.
To get out. And have a sack, you know, yeah. Kit bag.
Did it feel... odd, because you left home.
Especially living in the Nissen hut with all these other girls just for a week.
Yeah.
Got used to it, though.
And would you have stayed with these girls?
No.
Or was just, you just kind
don't,
of...
I don't really know them. Don't think I went with any of them again.
Yeah, yeah.
They were all doing different things. Some were cooking, some were... I don't know what they were doing.
But it was just like a sort of an orientation week. It was just to get your... What, get your
all the
assembled,
kit? Yes, kitted out.
Did you get your uniform on the first day then, or?
Yeah. Do you know, I can't remember that. Must have done.
Yeah.
Must have done.
And you did some marching.
And when we got to Morecambe, yes, yes.
Right.
And we had passing out parade and learned how...
What, at the end of the week?
I think we were at Morecambe a month.
Okay, so you went from Gloucester
for a week
to Morecambe. And what was that a different bunch of girls then?
Oh, I think so, yes. It was only when I got to Brighton that I was in with Anne Dolby and Georgina that her husband was in Tangmere. That's how we got friendly. Then I got friendly with the girl and she was in the office.
Yeah. Yeah.
And she recommended a place in Torquay to have a honeymoon. That Grandad and I went honeymoon to Torquay.
So, so you went to Morecambe, but that was for a month.
Yes.
And was that more marching?
Just marching.
Any other training? Or?
No other training, no, just marching.
And how did they know what you can do? Did you have to tell them, or do they give you a test?
We had interviews, and that's when they wanted to know what I was doing.
Yeah.
In private, you know, in private life.
What did you do the rest of the time, then?
Pardon?
What did you do the rest of the time?
God,
to just...
I don't know, got...
Do what
I know, told. It was a blackout, and this house we stayed in was just gloomy.
Yeah.
Do you know, and I can't remember the meals. I know someone had gone through my case and took a collar. So that must have been one of the girls that were there. I can't remember those at all.
And this was, so you were staying in a house in Morecambe rather than this out in the
house? Right. I expect the woman was paid, you see, to have us there.
Right.
I don't remember making friends there at all. Wasn't it fun? You so take people,
you do, don't you?
And I thought it did, so we got to Brighton, I did.
So at the end of the Morecambe month,
we were all
you were told...
To go, we all had to get to Bournemouth.
Right. And when you had a... Did you say you had a passing out parade or something?
Yes.
Was that in Morecambe?
That was in Morecambe, yes.
Did your parents come to that, or it's just for you?
Just for the us, WAAFs.
And then they basically they tell you where you're going.
That's
next.
Right. That was, I can't remember how I was told or anything like that.
Were you the only one to go to Brighton? Do you think, or
I don't think
that
so.
One?
I think like a group of us must have gone.
Okay.
But I can't remember that.
Yeah, and. When so you're sent to Brighton, when you go to Brighton, do you know for how long it's going to be, or
do you just go? Because it was Bournemouth, we didn't know how long we were going to be at Bournemouth.
Yeah.
Because I bought my wedding ring there. It was a jeweller's along there. And it could only get to platinum.
So we went to Brighton. Were you still coming home to London?
That's what I didn't get home as quick from Bournemouth. I can't remember how long we were at Bournemouth.
Yeah.
Your dad was a friend that was here, you know.
Yeah. So
it's funny, I can blot out things. I do blot out things.
Yeah. And yet some things you know really clearly.
Yes,
it's
can see it. And other things I can blot out and forget it completely.
Yeah. So when you're in Brighton, I mean, you're working on the seafront,
yes,
basically.
Yes, in the Metropole, yeah.
And was it odd? I mean, did you see planes flying over?
No. It was worse when I got back and had your dad.
Yeah.
I was in Queen Charlotte's and we could watch the doodle bugs going across, you know, with all the flame outside the back of it.
Yeah.
We knew it was going to drop it somewhere.
Oh.
Didn't have anything like that. We had all barbed wire across the front, of course.
Yeah.
But nothing else to...
Just make sure I haven't got... I want to ask it, because again, Dad's quite hazy about, you know, the later years of the war. But... So basically, I mean, it was quite. It sounds like quite an office job. It's office work.
Right. Yeah, office work. The same as the same as I've been doing.
And you said it was like stenciling.
For all the officers, the Australian officers. Some had died, you know, and some had got illness.
Yeah.
It was all on there.
So all the information would come into Brighton. And it'll be sort of typed up, and it'll go off to different records. And
I suppose it would. I don't even know where I put them. I think we had a sergeant in charge of us.
Yeah. Was that a WAAF sergeant?
No,
or
it was a man sergeant.
Right. Was he Australian?
No,
or?
He was English.
Oh, that's funny, isn't it? That it feels odd that, you know,
yes,
all the British organise.
Yes, we're organising all this thing, and this girl and George with us, she did their laundry. She packaged the Australians' laundry that needed to go out.
So the... Oh, right, so were the Australians in Brighton?
Yes, they were actually in the hotel, the rest of the hotel.
Were they just the officers?
No, they weren't only the officers. There was other airmen as well. I think there were flyers.
Right. And this was their base?
That was their base, I think.
And then they'd send them off to an airfield?
They must do, send them to an airfield, yes.
Okay.
I had some fun with those. They'd come in the office, you know.
They must have been really far from home.
Yes, they were, weren't they?
Yes. So, sorry, you said you had a couple of friends. One of them did the laundry.
Yes, I can't remember what Anne did now. She wasn't with me. It was the other girl. She lived in Southampton.
Uh-huh.
And she recommended the place, the woman who went to B&B in Torquay for our honeymoon.
Yeah.
And she'd recommended it.
Oh.
And did she come to our wedding? I think she came to our wedding. And you think, really, you're quite selfish, aren't you? Because I think my dad saw to her. I'm sure he did. I'm sure, and whether she stayed the night at home.
Yeah. Yeah.
My dad was... I didn't even ask how much, you know, the wedding cost or anything. I've looked back and thought, how selfish I must have been.
Oh, that's the whole point of wedding.
As spoiled
though,
as my sister would say.
That's the whole point, isn't it? It's supposed to be a family event.
Oh, I don't know.
The bride.
I think Carolyn did more, didn't she?
Yeah, but yes. She'd been... Yeah, I think she was
and
a bit older
than I think your mum had to go out on insurance, I believe, for that wedding.
Did she?
Well, I think that's what Jean told me. I didn't even know that. Because Jean said she don't know whether she could have done that.
I think you can buy them off the shelf, can't you? Wedding insurance. I don't know what it covers.
Well, because Kirsty's going to get married, isn't
she? Yeah,
yeah. So when she can afford it.
So, yeah, because I haven't even got to the wedding yet. Can you remember any of the Australians? Can you remember what they were like or who they were or anything?
No, just a bit of fun, you know, when we'd meet up. I don't think I ever went out with one. I'd go out with a Canadian in Bournemouth.
Yeah.
And one of the Canadians taught me how to play snooker.
Was this in Bournemouth?
That's in Bournemouth, yes. But we didn't go out with any of the Australians.
None of us. And what was your day like? Was it a 9-to-5, or was it?
Yes,
was it
like
quite
that.
Military?
Yes, it would be like that. Yeah, no, I can't remember the time, but that's what it would be like.
Because it sounds like
you had to be in the office time.
It sounds like it was organised like an office rather than a military.
It was a military operation. Camp. Yes, it was office like.
Yeah.
Because I didn't like the sergeant, that male sergeant. I had my ring taken off because it had to be made smaller. Because he'd make jibes then, or you're trying to leave your wedding ring behind, make out you're not married, these sort of things. He wasn't a very nice man.
Yeah.
There's other things he probably said, that's why I didn't like him.
And were you engaged at the time, or were
Yes, I was engaged.
When did you get engaged?
Was I 21? I think I was 21.
So I've been 42 when you went to Brighton.
I think it was before then.
That year.
My birthday, I was called up.
Right. So you were called up after your birthday?
I'm sure it must have been probably towards the end of the year.
Right.
I think it must have been November.
Right. Oh, God, so you were in Morecambe in November, December.
I can't remember whether I came home that first Christmas.
Yeah. You can't remember if you did or not?
I can't remember.
Yeah.
I'm sure,
yeah.
Yeah. I can't remember that.
When you were working at Ovaltine,
I
mean, was London taking a hit for those 3 years?
No, because not until the... Was it the 39, was it?
Yeah.
I used to go up to London, and the platforms were full of people who were using them as shelters, and the smell when we got off the train.
Yeah.
Used to go to Gloucester Road.
Yeah.
And, or South Ken.
Yeah.
From Ealing Broadway.
Yeah.
And, so they were... No, we didn't... Because then we didn't have anything at Ealing, but we could see all the fires in the distance that were over at the east end of London.
But Kensington wasn't particularly...
No, we were all right there, you see. Never, and I don't remember any, you know, have to go into shelters or anything there at all.
Because you think...
I did have to go to night watching.
Oh, yeah.
One night.
Was that an official thing, or a volunteer, or...?
No, I think it was official. I had to do that.
And how did that work? Did they give you a uniform, or...?
No, you just had to stay there overnight.
Oh, and where was this? This was...
In Kensington.
At the offices.
Offices of... Wanda. There were Swiss firms, Ovaltine.
Yeah.
They're called Wanda, really. We all said the Ovaltine offices.
Yeah. So you had to basically raise the alarm if...
Yes, if there was anything. That's why we were there, in case any fires dropped down, I suppose, onto the place.
Yeah. Was it a big building, or...?
Not that nice. I don't know whether you know South Kensington. I think Anthony Laurel Thompson's got a room along in this. Queensgate, it's called.
Queensgate.
Mm. Lovely old houses they were.
Yeah. Yeah, it was because Becky worked near there, so we used to wander around. Okay.
So the years have got confused, really.
It sounds really clear, though. It's funny. Because I didn't know any of this. I didn't know.
No.
And so then after, were you at Brighton for long?
Until I got to discharge from being pregnant.
Oh, so you were at Brighton the whole time?
Yes, just at Bournemouth for a while. I don't know how.
Oh, sorry, so you went from Brighton to Bournemouth?
No, I went to Bournemouth first from Morecambe.
Oh, sorry. And that's then, where the Canadians were?
Yes. And then to Brighton.
And then to Brighton. Oh, sorry.
I stayed there until I was discharged.
In Bournemouth, because I don't know anything about your time in Bournemouth, were you in Bournemouth for a while?
Yes, I was at... Do you know, I can't remember where I slept. But I worked in the Exeter Hotel.
So you remember that still?
Yes. Just office work.
Yeah.
Again.
Yeah.
But you know, I don't know where.
Is that on the seafront or?
Well, it's not far from the seafront. It's just round, sort of round the back, not far.
Yeah.
Because I went there with Uncle Stan and Moira.
Yeah.
And I tried to find it, which I could find the hotel, but I couldn't find. I couldn't remember where I stayed. That's flapped up completely.
Oh, funny.
Can't even think back to it. I can remember walking to the office, the Exeter, in the morning, but I don't know where I came from. And I can remember buying my ring along a parade of shops, and there's a jeweller there with that ring in the window.
Is that in the High Street, or...?
Yeah, I don't know whether it was. Because there's some... If you go to Bournemouth, there's some gardens, isn't there?
Yeah.
It was just behind those gardens. The jewellers.
Yeah.
But where I lived, I can't remember.
Yeah. And sorry, you bought your engagement ring there?
No, we bought the engagement ring. Your granddad did that in Ealing.
But you bought the wedding ring.
Wedding ring, because he couldn't get any, he wanted me to do it because of size, but then it was too big.
Oh, see. And then... The work there, was that quite similar to the work in Brighton?
Must have been, yes. I wasn't timing, I don't think, then.
Oh, okay.
But
do you know, was it admin work?
Just
or?
Admin, oh yes, it was all office work, as I call it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Did you have friends in Bournemouth?
No, I don't believe I can't remember anyone special. I must have been with one or two there, you know, because we'd go to the club, Canadian club, and I said, I must have been with someone, but I wasn't so pally as when I got to Brighton.
Oh, funny. And is that what you did in the evening then, go to the Canadian club?
Yeah, went to the clubs there around about, near our Hockley's Hotel. No, it wasn't Hockley's was Brighton.
Exeter Hotel.
I tried to look for that, where I stayed in the hotel in Bournemouth.
Yeah.
I couldn't find it.
Well, in Brighton.
With the Stan Amora.
Yeah, oh right, yeah. And
that wouldn't be far away, because we wouldn't have long, we could walk to the office next to the hotel.
And in the evenings, you said there was a Canadian club or clubs? Just a club?
A club, yes.
And is that like, was it a military bar or something?
No, I don't think it was. I think they'd taken over a hotel probably down in the basement, that sort of situation. No, it wasn't military at all, really, I've been.
So after a day's work, you just have somewhere to go?
Yes, we'd go home and go to the hotel and have a meal.
Yeah.
Whatever it was, I can't even remember that.
And that was provided for you?
Oh, yes. You'd get your meals provided.
Yeah. And did you travel back to London from Bournemouth to visit?
Do you know, I can't remember doing that. I don't know whether I did.
Yeah. And was it, did you have a pay packet? Would it salary?
I think so. I think I did.
I mean, did that feel different, having
we'd have to meet up somewhere, do you know, I can't remember really.
Yeah.
Must have had a pay packet. We probably had, they must have had a called it a day in that one country, what they called it.
Yeah.
You'd have to line up for it, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Be in a hotel, I think.
Yeah. Well, was that different from the Ovaltine work?
Yes, do you know, I can't remember Ovaltine, how I got paid.
Mm.
Must have had a pay packet.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't monthly that I do now, and the cheques in the paid into. You had a cheque. No, it was all pay packet then.
And were you still seeing Grandad while you were in Bournemouth? Would he come to visit you?
I probably kept in contact either with the letters or the phone.
Yeah. And did you see each other? I mean, did he come to visit you, or did
not
you
at
go
Bournemouth,
to.
So I must. As soon as I got to Ealing, he'd be there.
Okay.
It was when I was in the office in the Wanda Ovaltine, he used to ring me at lunchtime nearly every day.
Yeah. Well, I suppose, were you near a phone because you were in the office?
Well, I was in an office, yes, typing in an office there.
And
the head supervisor, she'd be at lunch, you see.
And were you in Bournemouth for long, do you think?
I don't think I could have been there very
long.
I don't know, I can't, I'm sure I wasn't there long, but I don't remember.
Yeah. Cause you.
It was only be a month or two, if that, before we were sent off to Brighton.
Right.
I don't know why. You see, you just don't ask things like that. You don't ask why we're going.
Yeah, no, you just go where you're told.
Just told to go.
So did you have a. Were you supervised by an officer then, or how did that work?
I was thinking of the sergeant with the crown. Oh, I can't remember what they're called.
Right. Sergeant. What? And that's a WAAF?
There's a man with these stripes, three stripes. I'm sure it was a crown.
Right. So the how does the WAAF work then? Is it that you were in a regiment or in a?
Perhaps I was. Yeah. I don't know, Neil.
Yeah.
I think when you probably when I was 16 or whatever it was, I'd be older then, wouldn't I?
Yeah.
21. I suppose I felt I was doing what I was told to do and didn't question it.
Yeah. So when you, I just wondered. If you remembered how you'd be given orders when you're in Bournemouth,
well,
you know, who your supervisor would be.
Yeah, probably either the sergeant would tell us that we were going off, and I remember they didn't come with us, those that were in Bournemouth.
Right, so this was an RAF sergeant?
It was an RAF sergeant, yes.
Who was based in the hotel.
I knew he was in charge of us in the office, yeah, and he was very nice.
Yeah.
I quite liked him, and he's got a wife that lived at not far from Ealing.
Yeah.
She was a nurse, so
yeah.
He was different to the other one in Brighton.
Yeah.
Very different.
Yeah.
And.
Because I can remember, it must have been Bournemouth where I went to a dance. You see, that was at the seafront. Well, Brighton was right on the seafront at Brighton. And I know in the next hotel, New Zealanders were in it.
In Brighton?
In Brighton.
So was it a similar setup?
A similar setup, yes.
But you worked on the Australian.
Not for the Australians. I don't know anybody who worked for the New Zealanders, but
yeah,
I know we went to a dance, and New Zealanders were doing that. That they do at rugby matches, don't they? All bend down, and jump up. They did that. It's the first time I saw that done. There's lots of things up. I just can't remember my friend Reenie getting married.
And that was around the same time.
But yes. I'd come home. Well, I got your dad then.
Yeah.
And Reenie says, well, you brought Ian with you. I can't remember it at all. Because your dad wasn't. Your granddad was abroad, you see.
Yeah.
So he didn't come with me. But she said, Marjorie and Bob came. My sister, you know. No good, really, I can't remember any of it. So I don't know whether I can blot out some things that I don't want to know. But that was quite pleasant to blot out Rini's wedding.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm a bit like that. There's probably something I don't like or don't want to do. Perhaps I can blot it out, I don't know.
Yeah, yeah. And, do you want another cup of tea?
No, I don't, thank you. Pregnant, probably in the November. Granddad went abroad in the February, so he never saw me with the swollen tummy. Oh,
really?
And Ian.
And do you know where Granddad was? Was that 1943?
Oh, golly, because I think he went to Algiers, first of all, and I don't really remember. I regret that. He wrote to me most days. Abroad, I had a case full of letters and I got rid of them, never even saved one.
You must have felt you needed to get rid of them, though.
I don't know why it was I did that. I forget them. Why didn't you save one or two, Kath? Oh, you are immature, I said to myself. I call myself all sorts of things.
This is when you moved?
That's when we moved out of the city to.
Oh.
That was when it was. I'd have kept them until then.
Oh, okay. I suppose you thought it was no need.
His diary. I've got his 5-year diary, you know.
Yeah.
Because he'd work during the day, naturally, and do all the.
Yeah. Because I remember when. Didn't he used to. When he wrote a letter to you, didn't he used to have a code for.
He did, yes, for every paragraph.
Was the first letter.
Was that all this? The second or the third letter.
Yeah.
He'd use. But I'm wondering if they took. I mean, people. They must have known some, mustn't they?
But and what did Granddad do? What was his rank? Or what?
Well,
was
he went from pilot to officer. I didn't even know he was an officer until he came. We got to came down to get married.
Oh.
He was in an officer's uniform. So you never told me, and that was a surprise.
Oh.
And he went to, you know, pilot officer, flying officer.
Yeah.
And I can't remember them.
In the RAF, based in Uxbridge.
That's right, yes.
Okay.
Oh, I see, that's why I put Ian was, when he had the scarlet fever.
I didn't know Dad had scarlet fever.
That was when we were at Wallasey. That's what I've jotted down here, scarlet fever. He was must have been five.
Yeah.
And then, because Jean caught it. So they were in the hospital. I didn't see them, either of them, for 6 weeks.
No, I couldn't just visit them.
They were in isolation and wouldn't let me I'd see them. In fact, he was all right when he came out. His hair was all blonde and long. That's the first thing we had cut, didn't we? Not like we do now. And Jean didn't want to come with me. Jean screamed. She didn't recognise me at all, you see. But she soon got used to it. Oh, because that's what I'm putting. Left for Oldham, 1957, I put a query there. Left for London, Golden Lane Estate, Jean 8, Ian 13. Well, I've jotted all this down.
This is just the notes in the diary.
Because my memory, you see, so bad.
Yeah.
Because that's wherever we visited, I was probably naughty about this because I knew your granddad would tell me. So I probably didn't bother to remember.
Yeah.
It was very bad for me, I know. Because I knew where we'd been, because he'd know immediately where we'd been.
I remember we had spaghetti bolognese once, and he said that he was in Italy, that he'd been based in Italy.
Yes.
And that he couldn't quite cope with the spaghetti, because it was too long, so he brought scissors.
Yes, because we weren't used to that, were we, spaghetti?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
So one day he took scissors to the table with him, with the people
well,
who
some of the officers misbehaved, yes. He told me how some of them behaved dreadful.
Yeah? like what?
Yes. Well, especially if they were out drinking.
He always had tomato ketchup with it as well.
Oh, yeah, well, that's like Ian, isn't it? When he was a boy, he shook it in Wallasey, it all went down the wall. He's jotted down what he was doing. Swinderby, 43. Then he went to Wheaton, 43.
Yeah.
Cosford, that's the officer's place, I think.
Right.
Then Uxbridge in 43.
Yeah.
Up to 44.
Yeah.
Blackpool, 44. Because that's where he did his training in Blackpool.
Yeah.
No, I should be dribbling with these teeth.
Oh, yeah, he's dunking it on the ink.
Then he went on the Highland Princess, 44, to Algiers. Yes, oh, I did remember the right thing. I thought he went to Algiers, the first one. Then Naples.
Oh, Naples in 44.
44. Then Malta.
Yeah.
I don't know where in Tarfar is.
General Hospital.
And he goes into I forget what he went into hospital for, something with his eye, or did the plane crash that they got when they landed.
Oh.
It wasn't very serious, I don't
think. Yeah. Where was that?
Well, it sounds as if it was, I don't know, it was Malta. Because then he's got AHQ Malta.
Yeah.
That's still 44. So. And there's nothing else then. That's the finish, I think.
Yeah. And what's the mug on there? Is that. Because it's the.
Yes, he had that made when he was in.
Perugia.
Perugia, that's Italy, isn't it? I think that's Italy.
1945. Yeah.
That's when he came home, wasn't it, in 45?
Yeah.
That's when they made him an can't even say that now. Unpaid wing commander, which he wouldn't like at all.
Unpaid wing commander?
Unpaid, yes.
What's that mean?
Some of the troops were getting home and he wouldn't like that, especially if he wasn't paid for it. Your granddad wouldn't.
I don't understand what he was made.
He was given that, what was it, five lieutenant? I have to look it up in the book if I want to see what the ranks are.
Yeah.
And he was made wing commander, unpaid. It was that's not the word for it, something in Kabard, and I've forgotten that.
Yeah, acting.
Acting, or something. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, yes. Acting commander. And I remember him saying he's supposed to see some of the troops, because they were all disbanding everything, you see.
Yeah.
And he wanted to get home, but he had to do that first of all.
Which was what? What would
he
have to
do? Was
to
some of the troops so that they were getting sorted out, you know, to come home.
From Malta?
No, it would be more. I can't remember where he was based at the last.
Oh, it was somewhere in the UK.
It could have been, yes. No, I've forgotten that.
And he ended that in 1945. He wasn't involved with, you know,
yes, well,
Japan or anything.
He came home, wasn't he? Because Ealing was not quite two, was he?
Yeah.
So 44, 45.
Yeah.
Yes. So I think it was the May. And then he's got HQ 214 group, hasn't he? Base area. I don't know what all that is.
Yeah.
That's where he went after Malta.
Yeah.
And I often read it because then it seems as if I'm speaking to him, you know.
Yeah.
He didn't like Egypt. He's stationed in Egypt.
Yeah.
And yeah, I think he had someone to look after him. For him.
Oh, yeah.
He did a lot of pictures, you know.
What?
Because he doesn't put down in here what he was doing if he was sent off somewhere. He doesn't put that down. Probably not allowed to.
Yeah, in case it fell.
But he's been to the pictures, you get all that.
What? Sorry, he's been to the pictures.
Yes, Met Chambers, Wing Commander Headquarters, went to the Odeon, saw They Dare Not Love, with Jeff somebody and Paul Lucas.
What date is that?
That was June the 23rd, 1944. He had a short hand class. I don't think he'd ever go at anything, that man.
Yeah.
Shorthand class.
Yeah.
you never waste a moment. You have to be doing something.
So when you fell pregnant, how did you find out? Did you have to go to the doctor, or did you just feel?
I must have known. I missed a period. Mustn't he? That's been the first sign.
Yeah.
So then down in Brighton, I would see probably the medical officer there. I don't even remember that.
And would you have to tell someone, or would the medical officer?
No, I would have to go and tell them. Yeah, tell the medical officer.
Yeah.
I'm not sure whether it was in our hotel or in the hotel where I worked. I can't remember that bit.
Yeah. And?
Because it was something I didn't want.
Oh, really? You weren't expecting?
No, it was my dad who said, well, you were, see, your granddad came home from Uxbridge each weekend that I came home.
Yeah.
And he said, what else do you expect?
So you left Brighton in...
Discharged.
And that was December? Before Christmas?
November, December, something like that.
1943.
I was home in January.
Yes. And then you stayed in Ealing...
Stayed with Mum and Dad, yes.
And you just stayed with them?
Yeah, and took some money over to Mrs. Mossy.
Oh,
every
yeah.
month, I think, from Barclays Bank.
You would?
Yeah, go and draw it, you see. Draw what your granddad wanted me to give to her.
Okay.
Because I got I didn't get annoyed then, but I did eventually. Because Sybil, his sister,
yeah,
got married.
Yeah.
Just before... Her brother, Eric, was discharged from the RAF. She knew when he was going to be discharged, but she wanted to get into this 633 Greenford Road with her husband, new husband. I didn't worry at the time. It's only as I got older I realised what they'd done. And they'd paid the rates, and I don't know whether I was giving my mum any money at all to speak of.
Yeah.
Your granddad's money was going and helping them out. Because when Mrs. Mossy died, Sybil, she'd got another job and I didn't even know where she was. Thought she was at, I think it was Hines where I thought she was.
Yeah.
She wasn't.
Oh.
Because so the mother left the money to her and the house to... No, the money to your granddad and the house to her.
Oh.
But fortunately that she became pregnant and she bought a bungalow elsewhere.
Yeah.
So when I think what your granddad was doing, you know.
Yeah.
For them.
Yeah. What was, can you remember Mrs. Mossy's name? This is Alexander Mossy's wife.
Sybil.
The mother.
Oh, married name, Sybil. She's out in Australia. She's
her
sister, his sister.
Eric's sister. Yeah. Mm. And but Eric's mum's
died.
Name.
Well, she'd be a Mossy, wouldn't she? Yeah. Forget what she was before she was married. Actually, I had a phone call the other evening about 8:45. I didn't know whether it would be you or Hazel.
Yeah.
And he said, "Is your cousin from Australia?" And it was Alan.
And is this Eric's his brother?
No, that's his cousin.
Oh.
His mother's sister's son. Mrs. Mossy had a sister.
Oh, right. And Alan's in Australia.
She moved to Australia with her husband.
Okay.
And Alan.
Yeah.
And I said, "You don't usually ring me at this time of night. If he rings me, it's usually 8:30 of the morning.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's their time before they go to bed."
Yeah.
So I said, "What time is it now in Australia then?" He said, "Oh, about 5:00, 6:00, and I can't sleep." Well, after a while, we're talking inanely, nothing. And then he said, "I'm waiting for a call to bring Betty out of hospital. She got breast cancer." In a 24-hour, then I thought, "Oh, that's why you couldn't sleep and rest. You wanted to talk to someone."
Yeah.
Happened to be me.
Yeah, yeah.
Although he's been married before. This is Betty, is an Australian lady. The Anne, his first wife, died.
Yeah.
And they had two children.
Yeah.
Gary and... I've forgotten the girl's name.
Yeah.
Now he's married Betty.
Yeah.
And he had a daughter with Betty.
Yeah.
So another daughter.
Oh.
And I've got his phone number, but I've got to get the Australian code, because you have to do that before your number, don't you?
Yeah.
I couldn't even ask how she is.
Yeah.
Because they're doing everything in the 24 hours, aren't they? Because Ben had his... gallbladder and his keyhole and little holes in his tummy there.
Yeah, God. So, there was Mrs. Mossy and Alexander. So you went home to stay with your parents.
Yes, but then when after a while Eric said he thought he'd better go to contribute to the house, so they found us a bedroom there.
Yeah.
And the front room, so we had two rooms there.
Right.
And Sib was there married, you see.
Right. And sorry, you got married the previous summer of 43.
That's right.
So you were married, but you weren't spending, you know, that much time together.
No,
because you were in Brighton.
That's right, no.
Oh, you're actually, Were you... Were you married when you were in Bournemouth, or you chose the ring in Bournemouth, and then you got married in Torquay?
Yes. Married in England, in Ealing, and had my honeymoon in Torquay.
Oh, okay.
That's where it was.
Oh, where did you get married in Ealing?
Well, the church, the Methodist church, is gone. It's not there now.
Oh, really?
That's where I spent all my teenage years, really, with the clubs that were... So then I was a girl's guildry, not a girl guide.
Yeah, yeah. Whereabouts in Ealing was it?
It was just round the corner.
Yeah.
just walk to it. See?
Yeah.
But it's not there now. The shops are there now.
Right.
And then Muriel knows it. You know, I found out talking to her with Hilda and her.
Yeah.
And her son lives in Hanwell, which I know, of course, as well. So yeah. He knows lots of places that I talk about in Ealing.
Oh, and Muriel is...
She came from... Well, she's a Swindonian, really.
Oh, right. She just knows the area.
She just knew... With her son living there, yeah. You see.
Well, she's next door or something. She's a neighbour.
She's just over the road there at 15.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Actually, I met her. We used to go to town's Women's Guild.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was Hilda who was friends, very friendly with her, and went to choir practice with her.
Yeah.
And it was Hilda I got talking to who recommended this place to me. And Jean didn't know this existed, neither did I.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's quite a nice little area, really. As Jean was saying, there ought to be more of them, really, with a ward. Not sheltered accommodation, because you don't pay anything there.
Yeah.
But, it's quite a nice little place. I've heard one to the drivers who come pick me up with a taxi say, it's a nice little area, this, isn't it?
Yeah.
Which it is.
Yeah. And so you got married in Ealing, and then...
That would be 43.
Yeah, yeah. And in 1944, what... I mean, were you just sort of living at home while you were pregnant?
Yes,
How were you supported financially? Did Eric
draw some money out of Barclays, you see, each month?
That Grandad put in, Eric put in?
Yes.
Okay. But he was also paying for his mum and dad's...
His mum as well, yes.
Oh, his mum, of course...
I just had his dad's pocket money.
Right, and his dad had died...
Yes,
a couple of years.
Yes, when he was
about 41.
Yeah, when he was 17.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, okay.
He was young, yes.
So that was even before the war.
And the dad was only about 45 or 47.
Right.
He was a heavy smoker.
And did
the Scotch man? He was very Scotch.
Oh, really? Because he came down from Scotland, didn't he? From Inverness.
Air.
I always thought it was Inverness.
No, that's where he went during the war, did Grandad. And he was so impressed with the people that, you know, had him for a while. I don't know now why he went to Inverness. He must have told me. Because he wasn't in... We went there after the when he came home after the war for a holiday.
Yeah. And